EUMETSAT is a lively place during the week, as the crazy European weather keeps the people here busy. It is quite enjoyable working here, as everything seems to run smoothly and calmly, since I've noticed a couple of meetings happening in the cafeteria, where people meet up and discuss problems and solutions. While these kinds of meetings happen in the cafeteria, other more formal meetings happen in the council room, which can be transformed into a real parliament. This contrast between formal and informal seems to work well, creating an overall pleasant working environment. Phil has called me to join him today for a tour in the control rooms of EUMETSAT, which I'm very excited about. So, where are we going now?
We're going to have a look at the control center.
I see here a briefing room though, so this should be a meeting room, I guess?
Yeah, it's where we bring the public to introduce them to EUMETSAT and what they do.
So, okay, so we got a view here on your control rooms, I should say, because it's not only one. You have two, or a third one, a smaller one here, and two mains, one here and there. So what's the difference between the two then?
Okay, well, downstairs, the control room downstairs is for low Earth orbiting spacecraft.
Okay.
The METOP spacecraft and JASON.
Okay, so that's what LEO stands for then.
Mm-hmm. And upstairs are the geostationary spacecraft, the Meteosats, over the Indian Ocean and over Europe.
And what's the third little one? Maybe we
Yeah, very interesting. This is a Sentinel-3 collaboration between EUMETSAT, ESA, and the EU. Ocean mission, low Earth orbit, sea color, ice thickness, very interesting stuff.
Interesting. Should we go inside then?
Yes.
Let's see a bit more.
Yes, come on, let's go.
Where's everybody? What's going on here?
Yeah, we have three people in here all the time, 24/7.
For all the screens?
Ah, for all the screens. Okay, well, the control room's split in two, effectively. From the clock to the right is a testing and validation area, which is totally separated from the left-hand side of the control room, which we call the operational area. Okay. So two separate things. We can test stuff on this side, but not on this side. That's where all the users are waiting for data. But if you have any problems or software releases or updates to the control room, it gets pretty busy in here.
So what are all these screens for then? Can you tell me a little bit?
Oh yeah, sure. This part of the control room is where we actually control the spacecraft themselves.
Okay.
Monitor and control of the spacecraft. Here we have MSG1, MSG2 control from these four screens, MSG3 on these, and so on and so forth.
What do we have here? You told me everything is automatic, right?
So. Oh yeah, yeah. So we're looking at telemetry from the spacecraft, checking the batteries, the voltages, the currents, the temperatures, up to about 11,000 parameters, I believe. On the bottom screen is the actual control part of it. So, and this screen here is called the schedule, and these are the routine commands that are sent to the spacecraft on every 15 minutes, every hour, calibrations for the infrared, a couple of commands to make sure the image is centered from the spacecraft perspective. And this is called the procedure display. These are procedures executing right now. And here's one here. This procedure is actually, it's an operation ongoing right now. And what we're doing is we're reconditioning the battery. That's to say, we're draining the battery and filling it up to improve the capacity of it. It's not on board the spacecraft, but it's monitored from the ground.
So, yeah, what's up with the clock? Don't you want to change it?
Oh, no.
Before, but it's in the past, no?
Oh, no. Okay, we're an international organization. We have facilities around Europe. We also work with the Americans and other countries. So when we talk about time to schedule activities, moving antennas, we use universal time, also known as Greenwich Mean Time, also known as Zulu. So that's 2016, day 195, 10:04. And the same clock is over in America with the same time in it. In Gran Canaria, where one of our ground stations are. So when we say we're going to do activity X, Y, or Z at 14:30, it's not 14:30 at the local area or here, it's 14:30 UTC.
So there's no trouble of thinking, oh, but it's actually 2 hours more.
Yeah. International, universal time.
Are the people working here also only with that time and doing their work hours just with the UTC clock, or are they checking the local time as well?
Outside, it's local time. The minute they come in here, that's everything runs on this clock.
So for them, they're coming in at 10 and not at 12?
For example, yeah.